we want to simplify the given expressions involving negative exponents. And for reference, we have our exponent rules here in red. Looking at the first example, we have powers raised to powers, which means we're going to multiply the exponents. So I'll have x to the power of -4 times -5, that's +20. And y to the power of 3 times -5, that's -15. Now we're not allowed to have negative exponents in a simplified expression. So if we write this as a fraction by putting this over 1, if we move y to the -15th to the denominator, it's going to change the sign of the exponent. So in simplified form, we have x to the 20th in the numerator and y to the 15th in the denominator. And we just applied this rule here. And I think it's helpful to think of this as a to the negative m over 1. So we can see if it crosses the fraction bar, it's going to change the sign of the exponent. Now taking a look at our second example, we want to simplify inside the parentheses first. Well, 24 divided by 8 would be 3. And then z to the 6th divided by z to the 4th. Since the bases are the same and we're dividing, we will subtract the exponents. And since 6 minus 4 is equal to 2, we have z to the 2nd. And this is still raised to the power of -3. And now this 3 has an exponent of 1, and the z has an exponent of 2. And since we have powers to powers, we're going to multiply the exponents. So we'll have 3 to the power of 1 times -3, that's -3. And then z to the power of 2 times -3, that's -6. And again, it's going to be helpful to think of this as having a denominator of 1. So if we move these to the denominator, it's going to change the sign of the exponents. So we'll have a 1 in the numerator, and then we'll have 3 to the 3rd in the denominator, and z to the 6th in the denominator. And since 3 to the 3rd is equal to 27, we can write this as 1 all over 27, z to the 6th. And looking at a third example, we need to simplify this first. So this would be 2 to the 1st, x to the 4th, raised to the 5th. So we have powers to powers. We're going to multiply the exponents. So we'll have 2 to the power of 1 times 5, that's 5. X to the power of 4 times 5, that's 20. And we still have to multiply this by x to the power of -7. Well, x to the 20th times x to the -7th, these two have the same base, and we're multiplying. So we're going to add the exponents. So we'll have 2 to the 5th, and then x to the power of 20 plus -7 is 13. And the last step here is to evaluate 2 to the 5th, which would be equal to 32. So we have 32 x to the power of 13. OK, I hope you found this helpful.